Dr. Sadia, please come, and I need a loud round of applause for her.
Thank you, Zari. Thank you for such a nice introduction. And after such an excellent talk on GDM, now, what is this? This is PC Bhurban. When I came here in 2021 in January, I was expected this, but still, I didn't find this. And now this time when I came here, I think temperature is almost same as in Lahore. Bahut hi garmi hai. So coming to the diabetes. Regarding diabetes, when a patient comes to your clinic, we focus on what? What we focus? We focus on lifestyle. We focus on nutrition to some extent. But we focus on medication, that is maximum. Obviously, we want to achieve our targets. Being physicians, being endocrinologists, we try everything, we try every medication, but one thing is left. That we do not focus, what is that? Psychosocial aspect. Including myself, we do not focus in it. So today's topic is very important and a very different one. And I will talk about the psychosocial aspects for the type 1 diabetics. When a patient, a poor patient, who is diagnosed as type 1 diabetic, there are many stressors. The fear of lifelong insulin injections, the fear of cost, and fear of stigma, and the fear of impending complication, fear of future, the fear of marriage, fear of pregnancies. There are multiple stresses. And then culture, personality, the personality of the patient, its psychological aspects, and the support from the family, from the society, and at the end of the day, there is poor patient. This is a real scenario. A 26-year-old male doctor by profession in my hospital, in medical unit, known type 1 diabetic, he came to me. He said he wants to quit medicine as he cannot cope with this. He said, I am unable to control my diabetes and I am unable to perform my duties. So he wants me to write a letter to his supervisor. So he wants to change this specialty to a lighter one, to basic. So the multiple issues, he was in diabetes distress. So psychosocial aspects of type 1 diabetes, when and how to diagnose and when to refer. Living with diabetes is demanding and many experience psychosocial challenges. Effective psychosocial support can help to reduce stress and improve psychological functioning and outcome. Healthcare professionals feel ill-equipped to provide required psychosocial support. Type 1 diabetes is a major public health challenge globally, and type 1 diabetes mellitus is primarily diagnosed during childhood and adolescence. Many cases are diagnosed during adulthood. It is well recognized that living with and self-managing type 1 diabetes with and without complication is psychologically challenging impact on emotional health and social functioning. The incidence of childhood type 1 diabetes varies worldwide, ranging from 0.1 to 65 per 100,000 children younger than the age of 15 years. The age of presentation has a bimodal distribution with peaks at 4 to 6 years of age and between 10 and 14 years. So what are the challenges? Many, many challenges. Children with diabetes face unique challenges as impact of illness reaches far beyond the physical symptoms of disease. It is important to look at psychosocial factors associated with chronic condition like type 1 diabetes because they affect symptom severity and management as well as treatment adherence. The prevalence of psychosocial issues in children with type 1 diabetes is high, and these children are at risk of decreased psychological well-being. Type 1 diabetes related cognitive sequelae in childhood and adolescence. This is something very important because the executive functions, their memory, their skills, their attention, and their cognitive performance, they are low as compared to peers, and they have to do a very difficult task of managing their insulins and their calorie calculation all the time, and according to them, then they have to inject. So deficit in visuospatial abilities, reading and writing, and motor speed with smaller effects on intelligence. The studies identified early disease onset, higher hemoglobin A1C, and hypoglycemic events, DKA around onset of major contribution to cognitive decrements. Again, in young and middle adulthood, patients usually have generally lower cognitive performance, which was mainly characterized by slowing of processing speed and attentional and executive function deficit. And across studies, there is association with hyperglycemia as well as hypoglycemia. In late adulthood, again, there's many studies in older people with type 1 diabetes confirmed that hyperglycemia, in addition to pre-existing microangiopathy, was associated with cognitive decrements. Dementia, there are only few studies that have included type 1 diabetes in assessing the link between diabetes and dementia, but as type 1 diabetes, there's a risk of microvascular events, and then dementia is also expected in these patients. So what are the emotional effects of living with type 1 diabetes? Being diagnosed with type 1 in childhood or adolescence can interfere with developmental changes and cause psychological distress. Young patients with diabetes reported significantly more depressive symptoms as compared to peers, and anxiety symptoms, diabetes distress are slightly elevated in young people with type 1 diabetes as compared to peers. Disordered eating behavior, especially it is seen in the type 1 diabetics and especially in the females, can lead to weight loss or gain, resulting in impaired physical health. Bulimia and diabulimia, patient can miss the doses of insulin to lose weight, and they can even go with the binge eating. Later on, they can vomit it out. So these all behaviors exist in type 1 diabetes more than peers. Leisure activities, we always say, you are diabetic, you have to go for a walk, this and that. But for children and adolescents have fear of hyperglycemia with overactivity that impairs their quality of life. Parents sometimes do not allow their children to participate in extracurricular, and young patients hesitate to attend parties and functions in fear of disclosing the use of insulin or injectables. Again, a very, very big concern, especially in our society, diabetes and its complication, first of all, to get a mass, and then it can negatively impact on the sexual function in both men and women, with 25% reporting sexual dysfunction. And then pregnancy can be extra stressful given the need to maintain strict glycemic control and uncertainties around the possible birth defects and neonatal complications. Relationship with family and friends, socially, the society accept it or not, this is a stigma, there are many social pressures, so relationship is very difficult to make for type 1 diabetics. So what are the clinical implications? Living with a chronic condition such as diabetes demands three lines of work: medical, psychological, and social. And the diabetes-related executive functional scale has been developed to provide information about specific executive functioning and related behavioral problems. This is a diabetes-related executive functional scale. It has 77 points. I have just took a picture of the first page. To evaluate that a type 1 diabetic can manage his or her diabetes, we can count from this, and this has different points in planning, initiating task, shift, monitoring, organizing material. So we can assess in detail that patient is lacking in which step. The executive functions are problematic where? So we can assess that step properly, and we can that problem should be solved by exactly identifying that problem. Diabetes-related executive function scale is an important and meaningful research and clinical tool to inform the targeted interventions. So it improves the adherence and ultimately the glycemic control of youth with executive function problem and type 1 diabetes. DSME, this is something very important nowadays. Every diabetic, we force that the diabetes self-management, education, and sport should be there. And DSME should be patient-centered, maybe given in group or individual setting, and or use technology, should be communicated with the entire diabetes care team. There are four critical times to evaluate the need for DSMEs to promote skills acquisition in sport. What are these four critical times? Diagnosis, at the time of diagnosis, then annually when not meeting the treatment targets, when complicating factors develop, or when transition in life care occur. So at these four times, DSME should be. Now, screening for depression. Many of the type 1 diabetics are depressed. Providers should consider annual screening of all the patients with diabetes. Referrals for treatment of depression should be made to mental health care provider with experience using in cognitive behavioral therapy, interpersonal therapy, or other evidence-based treatment approaches. Because if we will not treat the depression, this is a vicious circle. This will increase the diabetes, depression, that is lethargy, lack of motivation, low energy, and it will come to the poor diabetes management. Doctor will not achieve the target, patient will not achieve the target, then thinking of complication, and this will so on, and there's a poor quality of life. So we have to break it with this vicious circle. The second one important thing is anxiety. Consider screening for anxiety in the people exhibiting anxiety or worries regarding diabetes complication, insulin administration, and taking of medication, as well as fear of hyperglycemia. So depression, anxiety, and third thing is screening for diabetes distress. This is something very important. Routinely monitor people with diabetes for diabetes distress, particularly when treatment targets are not met and are at the onset of diabetes complications. When screening indicates potential problematic areas, patients should be offered a referral to a clinical psychologist for further diagnostic and psychological treatment if needed. So do not miss this step. This is a diabetes distress screening tool, and it has 17 points. I have just took first two questions, and this is the feeling overwhelmed by the demand of living with diabetes, and this is from 1 to 6, not a problem or a very serious problem. So according to the patient, this question he or she will answer where he stands, and feeling that I'm often failing with my diabetes routine. And it has 17 scores total, and we can easily get it filled by the patient. And we can calculate the score with the emotional burden, physician-related distress. There are different questions in this. And we can calculate the score by sum of the item score and divided by the mean item score. If the score is equal or more than 3, then the patient needs a referral to a psychologist. So when patient come to you in the clinic, he or she is in diabetes distress, what as a physician we can do? Ask the patient, what is the single thing about diabetes that drives you crazy? And then acknowledge the things. Given the nature of diabetes, feeling this way is perfectly reasonable. Do not make her panic. Tell him or her that many others feel the same. Then provide good news that if you are doing good, then there will be the very, very less chance of future complications. So reassurance is very, reassurance is must. Whenever you provide feedback to the patient, always use a sandwich technique. First of all, talk about the good readings, the good days, that on those days you were very good. But then you, if you want to say something on the bad control and the bad things, that should be in the center. And at the end of day or at the end of the your meeting, again, wrap it up with the praise. So sandwich technique is the best technique to provide feedback to your patients, because these poor patients are already facing multiple problems. And always screen for disorder eating behavior. Whenever the patient suddenly readings are sometimes very high, when sometimes very very low, and you are unable to explain the reason, think of eating behaviors, eating disorders. Ask about the missing of insulin use or binge eating, and then later on they're causing vomiting. So these eating behaviors are problematic in type 1 diabetics. We should look for this, and this I just took from a study in which type 1 and type 2 diabetics, they were compared. In first, there is the blue one is type 1 diabetic. They're difficult to lose weight and control my diabetes, and then desire to be thin at the expense of good diabetes control, take less insulin, induce MSEs, and alternate between eating very little and huge amounts. So they are present in both type 1 as well as in type 2 diabetics. Physical exercise, children and their families must also be educated about the importance of regular physical activity, and patients and their families must be educated about insulin effects, benefits, risk, and optimum levels of activity, so that they have glycemic awareness and control before, during, and after physical activity. Social support is very important. Always talk to their parents, their peers, and the healthcare providers. the parental relationship that involves open discussion and active communication, same for the peers. There should be sharing experience of growing up with a person who always have a chronic disease helps in improving their emotional well-being. So there should be the groups where they can communicate. And in schools, teachers and school nurse should know about the medical illness but continue to treat them in the same way as other students. And then education programs, structured programs involving diabetes awareness and patient education are required. Printed education materials such as videos and booklets with illustrations may be developed in regional language to improve the knowledge and adherence to treatment, and develop intervention that consider various factors such as cultural influences, personal, family, and community resources, and provide a tailor-made care that goes along with the lifestyle of the individual. Meethi Zindagi is baare mein kaafi kaam kar rahi hai. Dr. Atif ne bhi is baare mein booklet likhi hai. So we have things available here. So this is again the psychological factors with the emotional crisis, diabetes distress, phobic reaction, and then psychiatric disorder, which are maybe present in the patient. And then poor glycemic control, poor quality of life, and increased diabetes-related complication. Break this vicious circle. This is a slide from ADA 2021 when we have to refer to a mental health care provider. This is a general slide for all type of diabetes. If the self-care remains impaired in a person with diabetes distress after tailored diabetes education, if a person has a positive screen on validated screening tool for depressive symptoms, if the presence of symptoms or suspicion of disordered eating behavior or eating disorders, if intentional omission of insulin or oral medication to cause weight loss is identified, if the person has a positive screen for example anxiety or fear of hypoglycemia, if serious mental illness is suspected, and if youth and families with behavioral self-care difficulties, repeated hospitalization for decay, or significant distress. So these are all the things when we need a proper referral to a mental health care provider. Diabetes is a lifelong chronic metabolic complication, and the psychological aspects of living with diabetes should be recognized and should be dealt by a medical practitioner looking after the patient with diabetes for a better disease outcome. So these are the psychological interventions such as cognitive behavioral therapy, motivational therapy, problem solving, which the psychologists are using, coping skill treatment, training, and family behavior therapy. Coming to the end, to bring the psychological intervention into the existing treatment regime, what we should do? Incorporate psychological screening and management at every level of diabetes care, sensitize healthcare professionals, persons with diabetes, and their family members about the importance of psychological screening and intervention along with other advised treatment. There must be an advocacy program at the community level to improve the awareness level of psychological well-being of persons with diabetes. Very, very important things. So it is important for everyone involved in a person with diabetes care to understand the individual life circumstances and how diabetes fit into their lives. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sadia, for again an excellent talk and on a very different kind of a topic. Let's hear from the house about the question and answers.
To manage your depression, either with an SSRI, either with any other antidepressants, a long list actually. So have you ever experienced, or what does the literature say? If the depression goes, would the HbA1c come down? Well, the patient will be getting the oral hypoglycemic agents or insulin.
There are multiple articles that treating depression will improve the diabetes control. There are multiple articles on it. And even in the clinic, if I will call example from my clinic, if the patient is not controlling and I address or I give him or her an extra time and addresses the problems which he or she is suffering, just by giving time to the patient and listening to her, next time when the patient comes, there is much improvement.
Unless it comes in a black and white and the peer review,
but
all that.
But whenever there is, you suspect that depression is more than, you can use the criteria. And whenever sometimes patients say, I am depressed, sometimes patients tell, and then you need a proper referral. And so that we can have a psychological help as well.
यस, अस्सलाम वालेकुम मैडम। मेरा भी आपसे एक क्वेश्चन है, बल्कि मैं हॉल से भी बात करना चाहूँगा कि अक्सर मेरे पास पेशेंट आते हैं कि अनकंट्रोल्ड डायबिटीज़ है, कभी 400 पे चली जाती है, कभी 200 पे चली जाती है, कभी 250 पे है, कभी 500 पे है। तो कई दफ़ा हम पेशेंट आते हैं, मैं उनको उन्हीं की उसी डोज पर रखता हूँ जो इंसुलिन की चल रही होती है, एंड आई पुट देम ऑन SSRIs और उनको एक्सप्लेन करके कि ये एंगजाइटी है, इसको थोड़ा रिलैक्स करें। आफ्टर 2 वीक्स जब वो अपने डाइट चार्ट, अपने शुगर चार्ट के साथ आते हैं, जिसमें फास्टिंग, रैंडम एंड पोस्टप्रेंडियल सारा जो होता है, एंड इट इज़ इट कम्स टू नॉर्मल विद द सेम डोज ऑफ द इंसुलिन एंड सेम ओरल एंटी डायबिटिक्स, और वो नॉर्मल हुआ होता है। तो वन वर्ड जो यूज़ होता है सर, दैट इज़ अ ब्रिटल डायबिटीज, इट्स वन फॉर्म ऑफ द ब्रिटल डायबिटीज, वन रीज़न फॉर द ब्रिटल डायबिटीज आर डिप्रेशन और एंगजाइटी। तो मेरा जो एक्सपीरियंस है कि अगर हम पेशेंट का डिप्रेशन ट्रीट करेंगे तो उसकी एंगजाइटी ठीक होगी, इसी तरह सर उसी का उसका ब्लड प्रेशर भी विल गो डाउन एज वेल। तो अगर पेशेंट किस चीज़ को हम एड्रेस करेंगे तो बहुत, इवन न्यूरोपथी, न्यूरोपथी में बहुत सारी चीज़ें सर मैडम हमारे पास आती हैं जो कि पेशेंट का पेन जो वर्स हो रहा होता है, इवन विद द एंड इट्स एक विशेष सर्कल चल जाता है कि इफ़ यू हैव गॉट अ सीवियर पेन इट विल लीड टू आप और एंगजाइटी होगी, एंड इट विल लीड टू सर्ज ऑफ फर्दर कैटेगोलोमीज, जिसकी वजह से आपकी थिंग्स गो विल कीप ऑन वर्सनिंग। तो इफ़ यू ट्रीट द डिप्रेशन इन अ पेशेंट, एवरी मेजर डिजीज हैव गॉट अ डिप्रेशन, तो इफ यू ट्रीट द डिप्रेशन इट विल गेट बेटर।
पेशेंट नीड्स योर टाइम,
यस,
बीइंग बिजी फिजिशियंस वी समटाइम मिस दिस थिंग, बट पेशेंट नीड्स द टाइम एंड दिस थिंग शुड बी एड्रेस्ड एंड व्हेनेवर नीडेड द प्रॉपर रेफरल शुड बी डन।
यस,
ऑल्दो इन पाकिस्तान दिस इज अ स्टिग्मा, वी डोंट वांट टू गो टू साइकोलॉजिस्ट।
अस्सलाम वालेकुम, मैं डॉक्टर ज़िया, फैमिली फिजिशियन हूँ। जैसे कि आपने बात की है साइको सोशल इफ़ेक्ट्स की, तो हम देखते हैं अपने जो है डेली कंसल्टेशन के दौरान, जितने भी कंसल्टेंट्स है, डायबिटोलॉजिस्ट है, एंडोक्रिनोलॉजिस्ट है, तो हम देखते हैं वी आर डिफिशेंट एंड हम कुछ चीज़ों में डिफिशेंट है, इस तरह कि हम ना तो पेशेंट का आइडिया मालूम करते हैं कि वट इज़ योर आइडिया अबाउट डायबिटीज़, ना तो उनकी कंसर्न्स और एक्सपेक्टेशन को हम देखते हैं। तो मेरे ख्याल में मेरे पास कुछ 15 साल से एक पेशेंट जो है आ रहा है, तो फर्स्ट टाइम जब वो मेरे पास आया तो ऑलरेडी वो 15 ईयर से कई और इलाज कर रहा था, ठीक है ना। तो मैंने उनसे पूछा कि डायबिटीज़ है क्या, ठीक है, आपका आइडिया क्या है, तो उन्होंने कहा मुझे कोई मालूम नहीं। अब 15 ईयर से उसको ये पता नहीं कि शुगर बीमारी क्या चीज़ है, ठीक है। तो जब उनको आइडिया नहीं है तो कंसर्न कैसे बनेंगे, और फिर आपसे एक्सपेक्टेशन उसकी क्या होगी, ठीक है। तो ये एक डिफिशेंट कंपोनेंट है जो हमारी कंसल्टेशन में। और दूसरी बात कि हम उनसे जब पूछते हैं कि इंसुलिन लगाते कैसे, ठीक है जी, तो इंसुलिन लगाने का तरीका भी इवन उनको नहीं आता। तो यही हमारी बिजी, जिस तरह आपने बात की कि बिजी क्लिनिक्स है और या फिजिशियंस हैं, तो वो इस चीज़ को मिस कर रहे। तो मेरे ख्याल में ये प्लेटफॉर्म है एक और डिफरेंट
जो
वी शुड हैव टू ओन दिस कंपोनेंट के आइस के बुनियाद पे, जैसे आइस आइडिया, कंसर्न्स और एक्सपेक्टेशन हम हर पेशेंट का कर लिया करें, तो मेरे ख्याल में साइकोसोशल इफेक्ट्स कम से कम होंगे, कोई भी डिप्रेशन में नहीं जाएगा मेरे ख्याल में। थैंक यू।